upline, the greatest upline who has kept the greatest show of the V going on for last 20 years. So we love you, Chief. Amy, we want to call upon Chief. Nobody can wait here. Everybody's just... Guys, is that all? Do we want him on that stage? So you gotta be louder. Are you really ready for him?
Everybody up! Everybody! Up there! unbelievable.
There was a time.
I love you guys.
A girl of a different kind.
We
rule the world.
Unbelievable.
You're outside.
Ever see?
We were.
Ah, you ready? This is it. This is it. Freedom, Bangkok, 2019. Are you ready? You guys are crazy. Good morning. Have a seat. We have so much to talk about. Firstly, please, I want you one more time to show your love for the greatest show just now. Hang on. Hang on. I tell you, that was the greatest show I've ever seen. I'm so proud of the people who put the show together, to the talent who was on stage. Unbelievable. So Freedom, please rise and once again show your love to the members of the greatest show just now. Unbelievable, guys. Unbelievable. Unbelievable. It was a fantastic show. I thought I was in London, not Bangkok. Okay. So from the greatest show, now you come to me on stage. And before I start, you guys have been very lucky. Because you have heard from your uplines, from AVP Sachin Gupta, we partner Dave Advani, my brother, we partner Sati Senathirajah. But let me tell you why I am here. There is only one reason why I'm here. Because throughout my 20 years of career building this business, once in a while, you find a diamond. You find somebody who believes in what she does, who believes in the DNA of who we are, that is rhythm, raising yourself to help mankind. And you guys are the luckiest people in our network to have her as your upline. And the one reason I'm standing on this stage today at a private event as chief is only because of her, AVP Sharfun. All right? She's the reason I'm here today. Are you guys with me? And you guys are lucky to have her as an upline? Yes or no? Yes or no? And then she said, Chief, can you come to Freedom? My first question, where is it? She said, Bangkok. I said, I'll try. All right? Because today, with people like Sati, Dave, Sachin, all right, with V partners like Arun, Adli, David, there is no need for you beautiful morons to listen to me anymore. Are you guys with me or not? All right, but since Sharfun twisted my arm, not with force, but with loyalty and love, all right, and that's the reason why I'm here today. Are you guys with me or not? And if you look at your uplines from Naren to Shantanu, all right, to Bavia, to Joy, to Manish, all right, they are true loyal warriors who never gave up the fight. They never gave up the fight. That's why you guys are here today. So you got a choice tonight. I come here, I do my usual hello, how are you, and excite you for 45 minutes. And then I go home. Oh, I sit down here and we talk heart to heart. All right? Okay? We talk for real. Right? And I want you to listen because we are sending you back after freedom to whichever part of India, to the Middle East, wherever we are sending you back. Excitement alone will not help. You need to redefine yourself tonight. You need to re-engineer yourself tonight. Are you guys with me? So if you are not rushing anywhere, then we can sit down and have a chat. Are you guys with me or not? Are you with me? So sit down. Now first, let's get it over and done with. To all the guys in the arena, from the bottom of my heart, I want to say I love you, my brothers. But to all the girls in the arena, I really want to tell you that I love you. Are you guys with me now? And tonight, we're going to talk, and I need you to stay focused. Don't take notes, because nothing I'm going to say. Okay, you see, this is the problem. This is the problem. You start saying, I love you, then somebody from Chandigarh will feel left out. They will say, I love you. And then the Mumbai girls will say, I love you. All right, then the Lucknow girls will say, I love you. So I love all of you very much. All right, but... yeah, love you, bro. And so every time I come to your events, all of you are opening your book and writing some notes. And I know this is the training from none other than V partner Dave. All right? But I'm not here to give you knowledge. Tonight, my main purpose of coming to freedom is to help you make some decisions before you go back. Are you guys with me? Because you came from a war zone, you understand? All right? And now I'm sending you back to the war zone, but I'm not going to send you back as wimps. I'm going to send you back as warriors. Are you guys with me or not? And the first thing you need to understand, the first rule that you really need to understand, that whatever is happening to you, whatever you are experiencing is not unique to you. Everyone in QNET and the V throughout 20 years has been through tough battles. Do you understand? All right? They've been knocked down, but as Dato Sri Vijay says, they get up again. Are you guys with me or not? But you need to understand how this journey of 2019, change, rise, conquer, is going to work. But before that, how many of you are seeing me first time live standing on stage? I hope I did not disappoint you. No, but sometimes people look very good on videos, you understand? And then you see them live and you go like, huh? So I hope that none of you saw me come up on stage and went like, huh? I did not disappoint you? Okay, that's important. But you need to understand that this was not my dream when I started this journey. A lot of people look at us come up on stage And, you know, Sharfun and the team makes it look like a rock star entrance, you understand? And if you come to vcon, you will see us going on stage with music, with, you know, all kinds of things. But when I started my journey, I never expected that I would go on stage and there'll be people who actually want to listen to me. Are you guys with me or not? Because you see me now, right? But if you met me 20 years ago, I was like a dried fish. Are you guys with me or not? All right, who didn't know anything, but was excited. And sometimes I'm very uncomfortable with this feeling of coming up on stage, and you guys, I appreciate the love you show, but I don't want you to think that I am like this today and I've been like this for 20 years. That means 20 years ago, you give me the microphone and put me on stage. You need to bring somebody to wipe the stage after that. You understand? All right? Because I'll be very scared. All right? I remember the first time I spoke to 20 people, my leg was going like this. No, this is human nature. All right? And I realized when we come on stage, because of the edification, you think we are supermen. All right? You think that, oh my God, these guys are unbelievable. Okay? Hey, we also eat with our hand. Are you guys with me or not? We also go toilet, it comes out one way only. Are you guys with me or not? All right? We don't go to the toilet and it comes out from our hands. You understand? No. But do you understand? That we are just like you. And the more you don't understand that, the more you will believe that it's not possible to be here. So everyone, from Dave to Sachin to Sharfun, all right, to all your leaders, I swear, 10 years ago, they were sitting there. I don't know who they are. They are just a face in the crowd. Okay? All right? Not like this. Dave Vadwani looked like he was lost, you understand, half the time. I first asked him whether he worked in the railway system or not, you understand? Because he was controlling his team when they came to their first vcon. He was like a railway conductor. Are you guys with me, na? Ticket, 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 ticket. You understand? That was what Dave Vadwani was doing. But I need you to understand this. That when you see us up here today, this is where you will be. This is your destination. Your destination is one day to stand up here with the microphone and share your story. Are you with me? So the reason you are sitting there is because you got to know how this looks. Because one day the view will be reversed. Are you guys with me or not? I remember Sharfun first coming on stage. Even at vcon, she was stressed out, crying almost. Because all of their journeys is just like you. Only our timing is different. Are you guys with me? So whenever I come and speak to a crowd, the first thing you need to know who I am. Right? This word chief and all the glamour and glitz, this is irrelevant. You need to know who I am. And you need to know whether you trust me enough to lead you, all right, through the next 5 years before you achieve financial freedom. Because sometimes when you see people on stage, you follow without. Oh, fantastic. All right. I got one more name to mention, which I didn't want to mention due to various reasons. All right. Guys, as you know, this is not possible without your uplines. And the names I mentioned earlier, all right, from Manish to Naren to Shantanu to Jitin, all right, to Joy to Bhavya, okay, and of course, led by Sharfun, they also were sitting there like this one day. And they also had a book, and I'm sure Jitin still keeps his books somewhere. That book where you're writing notes is a reference point. Do you understand? When you leave this freedom, don't think of what you gain here. The most important is how you feel here. Are you guys with me or not? This will help you max out. Are you guys with me? All right? This will help you beat any battle. Are you guys with me or not? This is 1 million times more powerful than this. Are you guys with me or not? So I'll tell you my story, and then you decide whether you should follow this moron or not. Are you guys with me or not? So like you guys, I'm seeing all the names of your teams and your cities and your villages. So I grew up in a village. I grew up in a village in Malaysia. Very small. Very small. You know what very small is? That means you go to the road, everyone driving past is your uncle, auntie, and cousin. Are you guys with me or not? There's nobody you don't know. Okay? And my mother and father were both school teachers. Their names are Padmavati and Senathirajah. Okay? So everyone says, I am son of Senathirajah. Correct? You are son of your father. I don't say that. I say I am son of Padmavati and Senathirajah. Are you guys with me or not? All right? Because Senathirajah couldn't produce me without Padmavati. Are you guys with me or not? It'd be illogical. All right, so because of our patriarchal society, all right, we always mention father's name. Do you understand? But I'm a believer in Amma. Are you guys with me or not? In the mother. Are you guys with me? And so my mom and dad were school teachers, civil servants, government. No paisa, very little money. Are you guys with me? And my dad died when I was 3 years old. So I lost my father when I was 3 years old. And sometimes you don't understand what it means to lose a parent. All right? How many of you lost a parent? Okay? It is the most difficult thing to experience. Do you understand? But I lost my father when I was 3 years old. So I didn't know. I didn't know anything about him except the stories I hear today. So today I know my father because of what people tell me. But my mom, I lost her in 2010. All right? She is the greatest woman on the planet, to me at least. Are you guys with me? So we lost our dad when we were young. So I have two brothers. I am not convinced they are my real brothers. I am verifying, but my mother is no longer around. I cannot ask her. Are you guys with me or not? But every time I look at them and I look at me, the disparity is too big. Are you guys with me or not? You know? But it's okay. Karma is karma. So Sati and Kuna are my brothers. All right? And my mom brought us up. And how many mothers here? Okay? How many mothers? The most difficult job on the planet is motherhood. No training, no qualification can prepare you. It is the most difficult job on the planet. Presentation, negative media, Google negative, Indian newspaper negative, koi baat nahi. You understand? All right? Aram se, no problem. Are you guys with me or not? But being a mother is difficult. All right? That's why when the mothers in the network read the newspaper article, they said, screw it. I don't care. I'm doing this for my child. Are you guys with me or not? All right? And that is the biggest motivation. So my mom brought us up, three boys, and we were naughty. Children must be naughty. If they are not naughty when they are young, they will be naughty when they are older. Are you guys with me or not? True or not? So whenever parents bring their children to my house, and I see the child very well behave, in my mind, I tell them, you are screwed. Are you guys with me or not? When the child grows older, the naughtiness will come out. So I was very naughty when I was young. All right? And my only naughtiness is, I love women. Do you understand not? All right? I was in love with this concept of women and girls. Are you guys with me or not? All right? All the guys were playing football, all macho. I will be in front of the girls' school like that. This, I was fascinated by this concept, all right, of the opposite sex, women. Because women are just beautiful, do you understand? But no, I'm not talking about Deepika and all this. Any woman on the planet has a beauty that cannot be explained. A mother has a different beauty. A wife has a different beauty. Even your own sister, all right, you can see the beauty within her. You understand, no? Men, except a few men on the planet, so my mother brought us up and we were very naughty. And now you cannot hit your children, correct? Not allowed. I am telling you. If you don't hit your children now, when they grow up, they are going to hit you. Are you guys with me or not? Today, you slap your child, police case, newspaper, you understand? Google. You think QNET is negative, you understand or not? But you try hitting your child, the whole of India will be against you. Are you guys with me or not? But my mother believed, no use talking to a child, they will not understand. Let the cane speak. Are you guys with me or not? And the problem I had was Sati. Sati is a criminal. Are you guys with me or not? Sati is a born criminal. And he will commit the crime and then blame me. You understand or not? So I come back home. I'm walking in the house like, Ma, what's for lunch? And then, wishu, wishu, wishu. And I'm like, what did I do? Then Sati will be sitting there like that. So, and you know, how many of you got beaten by your parents? Congratulations, you're going to be max out kings and max out queens. Because I did a survey. I asked all the max out kings and queens in the V. I did an interview and I asked them, okay, how was your childhood? Did you get beaten? Yes. So when I look at all the max out kings and queens, they were beaten by their parents when they were young. Now, if you have not been beaten when you were young, first thing you go back to India, go to your parents' house, look at your mother and say, Ma, beat me. Are you guys with me now? What is wrong with you? Beat me one time at least. Why? Chief said, only if I get beaten by my mother or father will I be a max out king or queen. Are you guys with me or not? And we grew up being boys. We grew up. We had a good time. And then it came to education. And you come from the land of education. India has the largest number of over-educated poor people in the world. Are you guys with me or not? And we will change that. Are you guys with me or not? Too many. You take one stone and you throw in Mumbai. PhD, MBA, MBBS. You understand or not? They don't even know their name. Parents are calling their children IIT. Are you guys with me or not? So, I'm from an Indian background. So, my mother said, lawyer, engineer, accountant, doctor. Four choices. Nothing else is respected in the Indian community. Are you guys with me? You go to your mother and say, I want to be a singer. Slap. You understand not? I want to be an actor. Slap. I want to be a tailor, fashion designer. Slap. Only four professions are respected. This is 30 years ago. Are you guys with me, you know? Today, your children all dead. I don't want to do anything. It's cool. Do you understand? All right? Dad, I want to be an entrepreneur. You understand not? But last time, it was only engineer, doctor, all right? Accountant, Okay, these were the lawyers, these were the only respected professions. So I had to make a decision what I could do. You see, I look smart. I only look smart. Are you guys with me now? In school, I was a complete and utter failure. Are you guys with me now? Sometimes when I look at the exam paper, I get scared because I don't know what's going on. Are you guys with me now? So I realized that I couldn't be an engineer because engineer requires maths. How many of you hate mathematics? We should all get together and form a website. IHateMaths.com. Are you guys with me or not? And everywhere, we attack maths teachers. Are you guys with me or not? So soon, the government will say, no more mathematics allowed. Right? Because you see, the logic of mathematics, it's stupid. Because today, your phone and your calculator can tell you everything. Now, do you remember this worst thing in maths called pi? 3.147. The stupidest thing on the planet. I hate it from here. From here, I hate it. Because today, you are adults. You are professionals. Do you use pi in your life? Do you go to the market and say, dal do pai? Do you say that? So my question is, if we are never going to use this, why did you make it so important in school? You understand? So I told my mother, I said, Ma, engineering, no. Doctor, all this cannot. My mother said, no, if you're not good in maths, you can still become a doctor. So if I was an engineer and I built Burj Khalifa, the tallest building, correct? When we launch it, it will be straight. After 6 months, it will be like that. Are you guys with me or not? And then Amma said, become a doctor. If I was a doctor, many patients will come into the clinic, but they won't come out. Are you guys with me or not? Because doctor, you need to know biology. Biology, I enjoyed. One chapter only. All right? Hello? Hello? Which chapter you think I'm talking about? There are so many chapters in biology. I'm talking about the brain. The nebula and the kabula and the kabila, you understand not? You see, I know how you think, you know. So I told Amma, I said, I can't be a doctor. Then last time there used to be a program on TV called LA Law. Nobody, oh my God, I'm so old. Nobody knows LA Law. Anyone? Auntie Ji, namaste. Who remembers this series called L.A. Law? Okay, obviously. You come from that generation, all right? It's so sad, and now I feel so old. L.A. Law, I don't know, I was too young. I saw it on YouTube yesterday. So L.A. Law is this law program. And these lawyers, you know, come into the courtroom and say, I object! You know, and they wear suits and all that, you know. And they all got hot girlfriends, boyfriends, you understand? I looked at my mother. I said, Ma, I want to be a lawyer. Are you guys with me or not? Then I went to college. Now, I come from a small town. You know, when you come from a small town, you go to Mumbai, what happens to you? From a small town, and suddenly you go to Mumbai, or Delhi, or Bangalore, what happens to you? You become crazy. Are you guys with me or not? You cannot understand it. You'll be riding your motorbike or riding the bus and you're like, wow. So I went from my small town to Kuala Lumpur and became crazy. Right? From morning until night, PK. Is that what you call it? When people drink? What do you call it? PK, the movie. But it was a tough life. I couldn't afford to pay my school fees or college. My mother didn't have money. I work as a security guard. I work as a waiter in a hotel. That's why I always respect waiters. Anyone who serves you, respect them. Do you understand? Respect them. All right? And today, any waiter, anyone who serves me, I always tip them. Very good. I've seen millionaires give $1. It's so sad. You understand? People who serve us, all right, should earn our highest amount of respect from us. Are you guys with me or not? So I work as a waiter, security guard, everything. Then I graduated. All right? And when I graduated, I thought, this is it. I'm going to be a millionaire tomorrow. You understand? Because when you graduate, you think, done. I'm going to get a job. I'm going to be rich. All my problems are solved. Do you realize that you are richer technically without a job? Are you guys with me or not? When you get a job, you technically become poorer. Are you guys with me or not? All right? Because when you don't have a job, you can wear shorts, t-shirt, sit at home and eat dal chawal. Are you guys? But when you get a job, you must wear, you know, Arrow or Sparrow shirt, whatever, you understand, and walk around. So when I got my first job, I hated it. I was earning not enough to survive. Forget to be rich. I'm going to come down and walk. Huh? Stay in your seats. All right? Okay? So, don't worry, I'm coming there also. But at the moment, look at the screen. Love you. So, when you start having a job, what happens? It destroys you. It destroys your childhood innocence. Do you know what I mean? When you were a child, you believe in so many things. You believe that everything was possible. You know, when I was a child, I had this series called Lifestyle of the Rich and Famous. Okay? Robin Leach. Again, none of you will know because you are from a younger generation. And they show Rolls Royce, Mercedes, bungalows, you understand not, in Spain, in New York. And we said, oh my God, this is possible that somebody from a small town can become rich, a nobody can become wealthy. And all of you, thanks to Bollywood, you also believe this hype. Do you understand? But when you get a job and you start life, all right, it destroys your belief system completely. You can't buy food. Do you understand not? You have to take an auto rickshaw. You buy a car in India, you go bankrupt. Are you guys with me or not? Because your car will be stuck in a traffic jam the whole time. So I realized when I got a job that this is a scam. The morons are calling QNET a scam. They are morons. The biggest scam on the planet is employment. Are you guys with me or not? Because in employment, all of you work hard and only one man or one person makes all the money. Are you guys with me or not? The beauty about network marketing, everyone works hard and everyone can become a US dollar millionaire. Are you guys with me or not? So I don't understand why the media, Google, is not calling job scam. Some of you working 10 years. All right? You can't afford to buy a house. You can't upgrade your car. Some of you, 10 years you've been working and you can't take your family for one holiday outside India. All right? And I know people in QNET who work for 3 years and today have achieved 80% of their dream list. Are you guys with me or not? Now, you fail to see this. Because the concept of a job is to psychologically trap you. Trap you, no? Go to work, come back home, 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 go to work, come back home. You understand, not? And you do this for 10 years, you become a zombie. You think it's a lie. You become a zombie. You actually become a zombie. You don't feel it anymore. You are numb. And the worst part is that this numbness will last a long time. I can look at your eyes today. You know why you came to Freedom Thailand? You know why you came here not for 4 days? Not to find answers. To feel for one time in your life freedom. Right? Sharfun correctly called this event freedom. Because when you go back, go to work, where's the freedom? So you are telling me that you were born to never have freedom? See, your grandfather was a farmer. Your great-grandfather was looking after cows and goats or planting paddy. Do you understand? Or doing nothing. But they still had freedom. Because if you look at our great-grandfather, they were not employed. They were not workers. They were all businessmen and businesswomen. Now, they are not Ambanis today. Do you understand? But they did some kind of business. They sold something. They promoted something. They made something. Right? So from 3 generations ago, all entrepreneurs, and now, what have you become? What will your children become? Don't say employment. Don't say good jobs. They are slaves. You are slaves. Have you heard this word slaves before? S-L-A-V-E-S. All right? This was under Kalam, you know, those days. All right? In America. The Americans had slaves. All the slaves are black from Africa. Do you understand? Some of you remember this movie where there's names like Kunta Kinte, Chicken George. These were all slaves. The movie is called Roots. The series, do you all remember? Yeah, the only 2 people in the whole crowd who are old. Are you guys with me or not? So, there is this series called Roots, and it showed... Can I remove my jacket? It's just too warm. Hey, calm down. Later you want, I'll take off my T-shirt also, you understand? Man? I always tell you guys, if I take off my T-shirt, you promise to max out, no problem. Are you guys with me or not? Okay, calm down. But you think about it. Americans had slaves from Africa. They bought them. And you are saying, oh, thank God, slavery is over. Correct? Is slavery over? Nonsense, it's not. Because I did a study. I did a thesis. On slavery those days and slavery today. So can we do a comparison? No, we do a comparison. So you understand who you are. Because you are very proud, shirt and tie, walking to the office. I am an independent employment person in India. The fastest growing economy in the world. Bullshit. Are you guys with me or not? I'm here to give you reality. You ask for the truth. I always tell Sharfun, don't give me the microphone. You cannot control what I say. As long as you are convinced I'm saying it with love, and I'm not... And guys, please, you are all very new, you don't know me. So in the next 1 hour, if I insult you, if I upset you, if I say anything offensive from the bottom of my heart, I don't care. Are you guys with me? I don't care. You are not my father. You are not my mother. You are sitting here and she gave me the microphone. So let me say what I want to say. You don't want to hear me, go home. Or get the earplugs, you understand or not? But just remember, I'm saying this because I love you. All right? But my opinions are very strong. I'm an activist. Are you guys with me or not? So today, you wake up in the morning. Correct? The slaves also woke up in the morning. Similarity number one. How do you wake up in the morning? Oh, y'all think y'all are in yoga land, is it? Surya Namaskar, you understand? All get up in the morning. Om. Oh, it's such a fresh morning. You are like me. 7 alarm clocks. Are you guys with me or not? 7 alarm clocks. Somebody is actually calling me. 7 alarm clocks you have, no? And your best alarm clock is always your mother. And mother's alarm is like the soft volume first, you know? Beta. Beta. Jaldi. Time. That's a soft volume. And you are still sleeping? Beta! True, not? Now, those who are married, I don't know what to say. But one day I may get married. And if I get married, first thing I will do is convince my wife. All right? And advise her on the various methods to wake me up in the morning. Are you guys with me or not? Not the shouting and screaming and kicking. Are you guys with me or not? But the slaves all lived in a barn. And sunrise, all right? The master will enter the barn and kick everyone. Hey, wake up! Wake up! Wake up! Mother, wife, mother-in-law, same tone, you know? Are you guys with me? Now? And now the alarm clocks, when you put the music, it's not like, you know, sweet music, you know? It's not like, Tujhe dekha to hai jana. It's not like that. Then when you will go to deep sleep, now your music all like, wake up, you got wake up, you understand or not? What's the difference? No difference. You're forced to start your day against your free will. If there's nothing to do, will you get up at 6 o'clock in the morning? Are you a moron? Are you a priest? You understand or not? A priest has to get up in the morning and do aarti in the temple, you understand or not? That's why he's a priest, I'm not a priest, you understand or not? My mother said, why you don't get up in the morning and pray? I said, Ma, that's for the priest. If I also do it, the priest won't have a job, you know, you understand or not? So let's protect the priest. Protect all the priests in India, are you guys or not? Don't wake up in the morning. So if you are a multi-millionaire, will you get up at 6 o'clock? Are you stupid or what? Which human being wants to get up at 6 o'clock? There is nothing happening at 6 o'clock. Only the animals are doing weird things. Are you guys with me or not? But you have to get up at 6 o'clock because you have a master. Don't call him boss. Don't call him company name. You have a master. A man who is not your parampara, who controls you. Are you guys with me or not? Your father controlling you is different. Your wife or husband controlling you is different. That is blood relations. But your boss controlling you, who is he? He's your master. However you analyze this, he is your master or she is your master. Your company is your master. They tell you how to wear clothes. They tell you what time to come, what time to go. You understand? Halfway through your office, at 11 o'clock in the morning, can you go and have a 3-hour breakfast? Can or cannot? Can you have lunch 4 hours? All right, at 4 in the afternoon, your girlfriend calls or boyfriend calls and said, baby, where do you all hang out now, girlfriend, boyfriend? I lived in Mumbai. What do you call that place? Dave or Sachin, you know the place where all the couples go in Mumbai? How you know? How do you all know? What are you all doing there? And I love this bandstand, okay? Because no sun, no rain. Everyone has an umbrella. This is so romantic. And I used to go to Mumbai. I used to live in Mumbai. All right. I used to walk near the umbrella, you know. And I just want to hear. What are they talking about? But you can't hear anything. You only can hear. I don't know. Is it true or not? How do you all know? I only hear that sound and you will always hear the girl saying no. True? True or not? Guy is kissing. But the girl doesn't say like, no, with a tight slap, you understand? It's like, nee. It's like Hindi. And I'm listening. I am there. First time I saw the umbrellas, I bought an umbrella. Because I thought, well, these people know the weather better than me. I'm walking around. No, but can you do that? 4 o'clock? Can you leave your office? Can or cannot? So you know why we start work in the morning and we finish in the evening? Why? Because in the olden days, there was no electricity. So no work can be done at night. So sunrise, work start, sunset, work stops. So the slaves used to wake up in the morning and they all come out. And the master will give bread with water and give them like that, one piece. And they eat while walking. Then their legs are all chained together, 100, 200 people. And they walk to the farm to pick cotton. So everyone walks like this. Does it sound familiar? Do you sit down and have dosa all nicely for breakfast? Or you rush out the house, mommy will give you one toast. You rush, correct? Then you enter a train in Mumbai. How is the train? Empty. You are the only one sitting there. Is it empty? Are your roads empty? You are stuck in a traffic jam, right? Going very slowly, just like the slaves. And then evening, the master will say, come back home. But there's one thing they did not have, and something you don't have, and it's the name of this event called freedom. Freedom is our God-given right. See, today I'm a multimillionaire. Forget my money. All right? It doesn't excite me anymore. But the most valuable thing Dato Sri Vijay has given me with this business, my mentor, is freedom. You don't know what it tastes like, you understand? So you will never understand this. But let me tell you, you know why we are fighting a great battle in India today? We are not fighting for the MLM industry. We are not fighting for QNET's brand name. The reason why my mentor, Dato Sri Vijay, is still in India today, fighting the battle for you, because in his mind, he is fighting for your freedom. Are you guys with me now? He's fighting for your freedom. He's not fighting the government. He's not fighting the media. Morons will talk. How to stop? How to stop? So let me tell you how I stop morons from talking. So when I started this business in 1998 up to 2000 in Malaysia, same problem. Media, corrupted officials all came and whacked us. You understand? All my neighbors, oh my God, are you doing that business? You know how they'll come? They'll come and talk to you like they're buying drugs from you. Are you guys with me or not? They won't come and say, hey, how's your QNET business? Is it doing all right? That's how normally they will speak, right? But after you come out in the newspapers, they will come to you and say, hello, are you still doing the business? Like they want to buy, you know, some hashish or something from you. Are you guys with me or not? So I go back to them and say, yes, I am. You understand not? Because it's a joke. When everything is beautiful, everyone is with you. Everyone will come and say, how's the business? Good? Fantastic. Hey, I saw it on TV, no? Positive lah. Sponsorship, something. When times are bad, oh my God. Ayo, yo. Beta. You know that? Now you go back for Deepavali, huh? You go back for Deepavali, all the relatives, right, will be looking at you. They'll all be talking and drinking free whiskey. When you come in, they all go, shh, take him. Like you got AIDS, you know, you understand now? That's how they act, you know. Hey, Defla is here, you know. Defla. So I, Deepavali, I'll go and hug everyone, you know. But they think like I got some disease. I sometimes look at my skin, is it okay, you know, I don't know. But when times were good, they were there, you know. Right? Your problem is you didn't make money earlier. If you made a lot of money when times were good, your relatives all will be dancing around you. Are you guys with me or not? Yes. You come for Deepavali, they will have the two sticks, you know. What's this called? The dance? Dandiya. All are done there. That's what they'll be doing. If you made money, if you are a millionaire in QNET, government is wrong, you know. You are right. But today you haven't made millions. So your relatives are all laughing at you. So I realize the only way to shut up the world, number one, quit. Give up. All right? You want to shut them up, correct? Announce, I no longer do QNET. That's the first option, correct? Logical or not logical? Logical. You quit. But after you quit, where do you go? What is your option? If you quit today, what is your option? The only place you can go is go back to the traffic jam. Go to work, come back home, 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 go to work, come back home. And after 30 years, you will still be broke. Are you with me? When I ask you a question, you must reply, yes, chief. Are you with me?
Yes, chief.
So option one, quit. Option two, succeed. You understand or not? Prove them wrong. Get your checks up. Pay the price, because trust me, the bigger your car becomes, the quieter your relatives become. Are you guys with me or not? Because first Deepavali, I went in a Toyota. Alright? Then into a BMW, then into a Mercedes, then into an R8, then into a Porsche. You understand or not? They will keep quiet. So you must decide tonight, freedom. What is your choice? Quit or succeed? Which one do you want? Make it easier for you to understand. Quit or success? Which one do you want? That's the first decision I want you to make tonight. The first decision that I want you to make tonight is you are not going to quit. You understand? No matter what happens, no matter how tough this journey becomes, no matter how painful this journey becomes, make me a promise tonight here in freedom that you will never, 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 never give up. Are you with me? Because if you do give up, what are you going to be? If you give up, you will only become a slave to somebody else. And that is unacceptable to me, to Dato Sri, to Japa, to Sharfun. You think Sharfun needs more money? Right? You think we are fighting for this so that your BVs can contribute to our wealth? You are sadly mistaken. We max out whether you are here or not. Are you guys with me or not? But the reason we are having this, because we believe that you must not die as a slave. That you must die one day, but you must be a free man and a free woman. Are you guys with me or not? Now, I don't know. I don't know how much money you're going to make. I can tell you that I've seen morons max out. Are you guys with me or not? If I can max out, guaranteed you can max out. Are you guys with me or not? Are you guys with me? So the only way to shut up the world, right, is not by you getting depressed. It's not by you getting scared. Right? It's by you achieving great success. Are you guys with me or not? And today, Dato Sri Vijay, Japa, all your uplines, we made one decision. India will be number one for QNET worldwide. Are you guys with me now? Because, not because of what's happening. Let them talk. Let them talk. You perform. Are you guys with me now? Yes, it's a bit more difficult. You mention QNET, they will say, ayo, yo. These are the same guy who has done 300 really illegal things last week in his life. Are you guys with me or not? But guys, are you willing to die as a slave? Do you want to go to work, come back home for the rest of your life? You want your children to watch you as a slave or as a warrior? See, your mother-in-law may not appreciate the decisions you are making today, but your children will. Because one day, you are going to die. Yes or no? You are going to die. And when you die, somebody is going to meet your children after you die. True? I'll tell you a story. My uncle, my periya, that means my mom's older sister's husband, passed away at 91. Passed away at 91, and I was there in his funeral house, all right? And one lady came, and she saw me talking and everything. And she looked and said, are you Ati's son? My father's name is Senathirajah. They call him Ati. And she asked, are you Ati's son? I said, yes. I remember your father. You are just like him. And she started telling me stories of my father. So one day you are going to die. True? Yes, no? Yes. Are you sure or not sure whether you're going to die? Guaranteed, one day you're going to die. Yes or no? Yes. And somebody is going to meet your child in a bus, in a train, in a flight. And then they're going to look at your child and say, oh my God, I know your mother. And then she's going to tell your child a story about you. Now, what story do you want your child to hear? Oh, your mother went to work, came back home. Went to work, came back home. Went to work, came back home. Went to work, came back home again, beta. Went to work, came back home. Went to work. Is that the story you want your children to hear? But can you imagine the story now? People will say, your mother became an entrepreneur with a great company called QNET. And this company came into India to change lives. But sad to say, nobody wanted this company to succeed. But your mother wanted this company to succeed. And your mother one day flew to Bangkok. Your father said, don't fly. Your grandparents said, don't fly. But your mother flew to Bangkok to listen to this man speak. All right? This man also is no longer around. You can find him on YouTube. Uncle Pathman, are you guys with me or not? All right, so your mother went, because if you die, most probably I won't be around also. Your mother went to this event called Freedom. And your mother came back to India with no more fear. And she made the decision that she will fight for her dreams. And she went all over India, stood in small meetings and big meetings. And she became the greatest success story in QNET India. She became a max out queen. And then one day we all went to Malaysia for this big event called V Malaysia to see one man, Dato Sri Vijay Ishwaran, live on stage. And that was the greatest day in your mother's life, because your mother was invited on stage as a V partner on that day. Are you guys with me now? And today, even though your mother is dead, beta or beti, there are millions of people all over India and all over the world who still talk about your mother today, who shows videos about your mother, who holds your mother in high esteem. Now, which story you want your child to hear? And that story must be told based on your decision you make today here at Freedom. And that decision is, we go back to India, all right? No fear. What is it? What is it? What is it? What is it? So the first decision that we make together at Freedom There's no fear. But I believe in India. I believe in Gandhiji. I believe that the truth will always prevail. And Dato Sri Vijay built this company on truth. That we are 20 years old today. We are the fastest growing network marketing company in the history of this industry. All right? And you are sitting here today. When you go back, no fear. First decision, no fear. People will scare you. People will insult you. People will laugh at you. Yes or no? Are people laughing at you right now? Please do this. Over the years, many people have laughed at me, and today people are still laughing at me. Doesn't matter. Your camera has a phone. Your phone has a camera. Whose phone has a camera? Even Jio has a camera, right? Okay. The next time somebody laughs at you, don't talk. Don't do anything. Take out your phone and take their picture. Are you guys with me or not? Take their picture. Straight away. The person says, oh, you are doing that QNET scam. Wait, sir. 1 minute. What did you say? QNET scam. 8 minutes, sir. 8 minutes. Sir. No problem, sir. 1 minute, 1 minute. Hey, what are you doing? 1 minute, sir. 1 minute. I just said. Okay, thank you, sir. Thank you, thank you, thank you. Your photo is there in my phone now. You understand? So, take their photo. Take their photo. Are you guys with me now? You just take. Firstly, they will panic. They don't know what's going on. They might run away. Are you guys with me now? True or not? If somebody comes and take your photo, you won't panic. Anyone laughs at you, that means they are laughing at me. That means they are laughing at Dato Sri Vijay. Do you understand not? That means they are laughing at 20 years of sacrifice we have made. That means they are laughing at all the millionaires we have created around the world. Right? They are laughing at our dreams. Are you guys with me or not? Yes. So don't worry. Take their picture. Take it. Keep it on your phone. Next person, you go for Diwali in your house. Everyone said, ha ha ha, QNET, ah, ha, QNET, ah. 1 minute. Don't panic. You understand, no? Oh, I forgot my password. Don't panic when they're laughing. Laughing, see? Very sad. Are you married? Then your laughter should be better, you know. Correct or not? Married men laugh like that, you know the problem. Are you guys with me or not? But unmarried means it's okay. I laugh again. So you take their picture and keep it in your phone. Remember their name, their location, anything. Remember this. Because many people have laughed at me. Many people have laughed at Dev Advani, Sachin, Sharfun, Shantanu, Jitin, Naren, you understand, Manish, Bafia, Joy. You think they all got here because of their good looks? No. The world laughed at us. 1998, they laughed at us. 1999, they laughed at us. 2000, they laughed at us. And they are still laughing at us in 2018. And they will keep laughing at us until 2028. Are you with me or not? Yes. But take their picture. Take their picture. Just wait until you achieve success. Until you achieve? How long will that take? How long? No, 5 years is already there. You understand or not? You will achieve success in 2 years. You will achieve great success in 2 months. Who wants to achieve success in 2 years? All right, who wants to achieve success in 1 year? So success timing, your uplines are giving you the worst case scenario. All of them standing at the back achieve great success way before 5 years. Are you guys with me or not? Are you excited? Yes or no? So take their picture. Take their picture. All right? And store it in your phone with their name, their address, everything. When you achieve success, when you upgrade your car, when your checks are 2,000 US, all right, or whatever the equivalent in rupees, whatever amount, I want you to go to their house. Go to their house. Look for them. Go to their house. These are people who laughed at you, you know, bro. You understand not? People who laughed at you. People who before QNET was your best friend. Your cousins. We played marbles together. You remember? If you don't want to join QNET, at least shut up and be supportive. Yes or no? But no, this is India. India, today they can be your best friend. Tomorrow they can be your worst enemy. Correct or not? Because when you go 1.4 billion people, the country is complicated. How can your best friend not support you? If I have a dream, I demand that my friends support me. Don't join. Support. Don't laugh. Support. You understand? Your sister, your brother, your cousin, your mother-in-law. All right? But in our culture today, no. They will attack. They will laugh at you. They will question you. So take their photo. Remember their address and their house. When you upgrade your car from a Maruti to a BMW, all right, go to their house. Are you guys with me now? Go! Go to their house. Check the photo, verify. Don't go to the wrong house. Go to their house. Ring the doorbell. Ring the doorbell. All right? Now, you must do something so crazy, all right, that they are confused, why are you doing, and they think you are a mental patient, correct or not? All right? So these people laughed at you, true or not? Yes. Do you remember those who laughed at you? Do you remember those who are today criticizing you, yes or no? Do you remember people today who are insulting you, yes or no? Do you remember the people who signed up, made money, and now turning against you? Do you know these people? Yes. I make you one promise. I am telling you, we are not leaving India. Are you guys with me or not? Yes. India is our home. Are you guys with me or not? Yes. And we only got one dream. One dream. That is to make QNET number one in India. Are you guys with me or not? So now stand up. Stand up. You have to decide today. First decision, no fear. What's the first decision?
No fear.
What's the first decision?
No fear.
Now, second decision you have to make is that you will achieve success. What is it? Success. What is it?
Success.
What is it? What is it?
Success.
Now, when you achieve success, in whatever form, motorbike to car, car to bigger car, you understand? All right? Or you're a big dreamer, you want to land your private jet there, no problem, it's possible. It's possible. I don't care what your dream is. I am telling you, all dreams are possible. Are you with me or not?
Yes.
Are you with me?
Yes.
Look for these people. Go to their house. Stand outside. Ring the doorbell. When they come, remember they laughed at you. Do you understand? They laughed at you. You didn't do anything wrong. You're just following your dream. You have not done anything wrong. Are you with me or not?
Yes.
You made the strongest, most powerful decision in your life for your family, for your loved ones. This is your God-given right. All right, you have not done anything wrong, but people laugh at you. You go there, you stand in front of the house, ring their doorbell, take a deep breath, and you must laugh. Wait. Please. This you cannot do like a normal, like that unmarried guy there. You understand not? You cannot do. This laugh must come from within. This must be a yoga laugh. You understand not? All right? This laugh must come from within here. And you are letting out everyone who said you couldn't do it. See, Dato Sri Vijay told me, give me a million people who say you can't, And show me one who say you can, all right, and you will achieve your dream. Are you guys with me or not? So right now, you got thousands of people who are saying you can't. But there's one moron standing on stage right now. His name is Pathman Senathirajah. He started the journey just like you with nothing. And today he's living proof that it's possible. And I'm telling you, you can achieve success. That you can be a max out king or queen. Are you with me? But to all the people who laughed at you, whoever they are, take a deep breath. Close your eyes. I want you to imagine the faces of these people. Who laughed at you? Who didn't sign up? Who gave up on you? Who wrote a complaint about you? Who did you help so much through your life, and today that person abandoned you? All right? There's so many people who gave up on you, so many people who said you can't do it, so many people who laughed at you throughout your journey, not only in QNET, but until today. I want you to imagine their faces. Now open your eyes and look at me. You remember their faces? I give you my promise. I give you my commitment on behalf of Sharfun, her team, that we are going to stand by you all the way to success. We are going to stand by you all the way to max out, so that one day you can stand in front of all these morons and laugh like you never laughed before. Are you guys with me or not? Are you ready? Now I want you to laugh. Let it all out. All right? Wait. Let it all out. It's all here. All the negativity. All the people who say it cannot be done. 1, 2, 3. Are you with me? Laugh back at them. Are you with me? Are you with me? I promise you. One more time. You feel good? I promise you, this day will come. This day will come. If you have no more fear, no fear, and you chose not to quit, but you chose success, this day will come. 1 year, 6 months, 2 years, 3 years, doesn't matter. What is your choice? If you don't do this, where can you fall back on? Where can you go? What is your choice? You have no other choices. This is it. Tonight, you must make a decision that this is not a hobby. That this is not something you're trying. That the dream that you have found is a dream you're willing to die for. If your dream is so small that one newspaper article can steal it, one neighbor can steal it, one stranger can steal it, then it's not a dream that you're willing to die for. Are you guys with me? You must have dreams that you're willing to die for, like your parents, like your children, like giving back to your family. Now, tonight here, sit down, here at Freedom, you need to decide that this is what you want to do. This is not a hobby. This is not something you are giving a try, that this is something that is going to redefine you. You are going to be great human beings. You will be on stage, and I promise you, you will be better than me. Because I've got limitations today. But the world belongs to you. You understand? Millions will follow you. Thousands will march with you. Because we are not just a network marketing company. That we are here to change lives. That we are here to make a difference. And the first rule of 2019, three words I chose for 2019. Change, rise, conquer. And the first word is change. That you have to change. You cannot be the same person you were last year or 10 years ago. The Dato Sri Vijay, my mentor, always told me, Pathman, if you don't change, you die. He said, change or die. I thought he meant the clothes, you understand or not? So every year I bought new clothes, you understand? But you have to change. You have to change the way you think. You cannot think small, you got to think big. You cannot be afraid of every little rumor you hear. You cannot panic. Because you are today an entrepreneur. You own your own business. You got hundreds or thousands of people who believe in you, who follow you. So you have to change. If you are lazy, become hardworking. If you are a wimp, become a warrior. You just keep changing. So at this freedom, the one change that I want to see in all of you, your attitude must change from wimp to warrior. Now, I know when you are a wimp. You don't show it to your downlines. You don't come in front of your downlines and say, good afternoon. Today there was a negative article in Hindustan Times. I'm sure all of you read it. Please don't believe it. We must stay strong. You cannot. How you talk in front of your downlines? What bloody stupid article. Correct. Right? The company is with us. Our uplines are with us. Nothing to fear. We march forward. We max out. Correct? Wait. You are saying it. Like Shah Rukh Khan in a movie. Being a warrior is not about acting. Being a warrior comes from here. Being a warrior is 100%. It's not about acting. It's not about raising your voice. The first change I want to see in you is that you are truly a warrior. Because you have not done anything wrong. This is the greatest business in the world. This business concept of QNET, direct selling, network marketing, will change the world in the next 10 or 20 years. We create more millionaires than any other business on the planet. Are you with me? So you need to be a warrior. Now, being a warrior means nothing. Nothing can stop you. You understand? All your Bollywood movies, Bajirao Mastani, you understand not? All right, Bahubali, you understand not? All your Indian movies only express one thing, warriors. Are you guys with me or not? Everything is about warriorship. But let me ask you, are there really warriors in India? Oh, no, I'm not convinced. Wait. I think there's something wrong with my hearing. I can't hear. Where are the warriors of India? Hang on. See, it's easy to stand here with me. It's easy to stand here with me and be strong while we are in Thailand. Are you guys with me? But tomorrow, you are landing back in India. the greatest country in the world. You are landing back in India. And they know you are coming. They know you are coming. And they know once the freedom warriors land in India, India is going to explode. Are you guys with me or not? So, they will try everything. They will try everything. But you have to decide when they try something, are you going to be a wimp or warrior? Are you guys with me or not? Wait. Be honest with me. This answer must come from your heart. So tomorrow you land in India. Headlines in your local newspaper. QNET scam IRs return from Thailand. Wimp or warrior? Tomorrow you land in India and you hear rumors that your uplines have been picked up by some police or something like that. Wimp or warrior? Tomorrow you go to a presentation, 1,000 people are supposed to come, and then it got disturbed, and only 50 people came. Wimp or warrior? When your own wife, your own husband tells you, you cannot do this business, you will not succeed. Wimp or warrior? After doing 10 presentation, 20 presentation, 30 presentation, 40 presentation, and nobody signs up. Wimp or warrior? Are you with me? That whatever happens, remember why you are doing this. Remember who you are doing this for. And don't allow a piece of paper or an internet search or rumors steal your dream so easily. Because nothing can steal the dreams of Dato Sri Vijay and Japa. We have fought more battles than you. We have stood strong to protect your dreams. Are you with me? So the first change from whim to warrior, second is to rise. Whatever you are doing right now is not enough. Whatever you think you are doing right now is not enough. This year, 2019, freedom must rise. Are you guys with me or not? I want your plans, your presentations to increase. I want your BVs to increase. I want your checks to increase. I want the energy in your organization to rise. Are you with me? That this year, we will rise above the negativity. We will rise above everything. Nothing and nobody will bring us down anymore. Are you with me? With the system your uplines have put, shut up, listen, and do. Are you guys with me? Now, when you go back to India right now, they must feel you. They must know, Pakistan, they must know that you are back. They must know that you have come back not to hide under a rock, all right? Not to hide behind a coconut tree. That you have come back to India, to Pakistan, to UAE, to all the countries, and you have come back with one purpose, that is to rise. Are you guys with me or not? We will rise in 2019. Finally, the final word I use this year is to conquer. And I don't mean conquer a country. The first thing that you must conquer is yourself. Your greatest enemy is not out there. It's you. You know this. You know your weakness. You know your weakness. You know when you are lazy. You know when you don't do presentation. You know when you get afraid sometimes. You know when the negativity is overwhelming on your head. You know this. But this year you will conquer that. Are you guys with me? That you will conquer your fear, you will conquer your ego, you will conquer all the negativity, and ultimately we will conquer your countries and your markets and make them number one in the world. Are you guys with me or not? And this year, we made a promise to each other, me and Sharfun, that this year, Change, Rise, Conquer is going to redefine her organization. It's going to redefine each one of you as the warriors of Dato Sri Vijay and Japadas Bismarck. But I need you to believe in one thing. I need you to believe that you are not alone. That the reason I'm coming here today in Thailand, the reason why my Wednesday message comes out every Wednesday for the past 4 years, the reason why we have 2 vcons every year, is because we want you to know that you are not alone. That every step you take, every rejection you face, every negativity you face, you are not alone. We are with you. Dato Sri Vijay is with you. Japadas is with you. I am with you. Dev Advani is with you. Sachin is with you. Sharfun is with you. Shantanu is with you. Manesh is with you. Joy is with you. Bhavya is with you. Jitin is with you. Are you guys with me? Naren is with you. Are you guys with me? But now when you go back, this week, you're going back on a Monday, correct? This week, I want your organization to break records. Is that possible? Yeah. This week, when you go back, all right, the whole of India must be vibrating with the power of freedom. Are you guys with me or not? Yeah. This week, when you go back, make sure your phone has enough battery to take the photo of every moron who laughs at you. Are you with me? Yeah. That this week when you go back, everyone who supported you, your amma, your dad, your grandfather, everyone who supported you and never turned negative, go home and give them a hug. Give them a hug. And say thank you. Are you guys with me or not? Say thank you to the people who never gave up on us. And guys, I want you to know one thing. That this year, 2019, I have a feeling. I've never been wrong. I've never said this in 2018, 17, 16, 15. You can ask Sachin. But this year, I have a feeling in my heart that the storm, the rain, the floods, all right, the ferocious tigers and lions, this year, they're all going to move aside so that we can move forward, all right, and change more lives all around the world. Are you guys with me or not? This year belongs to us. I need you to follow your heart, remember your dream. I want to see all of you at vcon, all right? I think you have coming for the second or the first vcon, whatever. I want you to stay online, all right? Make sure you watch the Wednesday message every week. But most importantly, this year is change, rise, conquer. Are you guys with me or not? And to all of you, love you, to all of you, on behalf of Dato Sri Vijay and Japa, I want to thank you for your loyalty, for your love, for never giving up on us, because we promise we will never, ever give up on you. Are you guys with me? So I love you very much. I love you guys very much. And this year, 3 words, change.
Change, rise, conquer.
Freedom, I love you. Thank you very much. I love you guys so much. This year belongs to you. Change, rise, conquer. I love you. Thank you. Thank you so much. I love you guys. Thank you. Freedom, unbelievable. I love you guys so much. Thank you very much.
बजने दे धड़क धड़क ढोलता से धड़क धड़क भंडारा झिड़क झिड़क
मंदारी खड़क खड़क झटक मटक सली 2019 belongs to you. Change, rise, conquer.
बड़ी चली आ जो थी चिंगारी छोटी चिंगारी।